boys, welcome to the 14.20 patch rundown. So, there's two best ways to play Urgot right now, mostly depending on your playstyles. I'll break down the rune page near the end of the video, but just to give you a little synopsis. Phase Rush is the best and most consistent way to play Urgot right now. PTA has three sub-rune ways to play the game right now. So, this patch is really important, and it's important that you identify what kind of player you are as an individual. But if you just want to be a standard Urgot player, I've given you all the runes and options and the build paths. But please keep in mind, to be optimal in this patch, you have to have some kind of personal identity with the game. There is no such thing as like just being a standard good Urgot player anymore. You have to excel at something to be a good Urgot player. The best way to play Urgot as default, you can probably just do it like, you can coast by like a high B level, high A level. But if you want to be an S tier Urgot player right now, your adaptability is really important in this meta. So check out the video, let me know how you think. So to start off this patch, I'm going to give you my two tier lists, one from 14.19 and one from 14.20. So you're going to immediately see the differences in how my opinion on items have changed and the new technology that has been discovered. So on the left side, 14.19, right side, the current tier list for 14.20. So the main thing, the main takeaway you're going to see is Shojin went from D tier to S tier, and that was mostly because of my ignorance of the item. So when all the items got nerfed, Shojin got off pretty light, especially for Urgot, because they removed 20 ability haste. Urgot doesn't like ability haste. Well, he does, but you know, it's like one of his least luxurious stats. You can, if an item has haste, it's like, sure, whatever. But if it has removed 20 ability haste, it's a nerf that doesn't impact Urgot at all, because Urgot W is ability haste locked, Urgot E, you're casting it once in a team fight, and you're using your Q two times anyway. So the ability haste in Urgot isn't a great stat. Shojin had 20 ability haste removed. So the fact that Shojin had 20 ability haste removed as his main nerf made this item really, really good on Urgot. So Yanga's Beef discovered that Shojin is actually pretty good. He also discovered that Phase Rush is probably the best rune for Urgot right now. And I moved Sterix from A tier to B tier. So I'm going to explain to you all the best build paths. I'm going to explain to you when to play these builds. I'm going to explain to you why I feel certain ways of items and their practical applications. So we're going to start with the best build path now, which is Black Cleaver into Shojin into Overlords, and then you build two tank items. So for the situational tank items, you're going to be thinking, well, you can look at the tier list to see which items are the best. But the situational tank items you want to be looking for mostly are Deadmans, Force of Nature, Warmogs, Unending Despair, Heartsteel, and maybe Jack Shou if you have Enchanters. Heartsteel, I only build it in a win-more position, but Shojin is the real big winner, and I think this is definitively the best build path right now. So you can do this build variation with Overlord's Bloodmail first, and then you can go into Shojin. You can do Overlord Bloodmail BC into Shojin, but definitively, Black Cleaver beats people 1v1. Black Cleaver is still an A tier item since the nerfs, but it's still a pretty good item on Urgot. You should be building Black Cleaver every single lobby. Sterix, you're no longer going to be building every lobby, so we're not even building Sterix unless we're building Heartsteel. So the best build path, Black Cleaver, Shojin, Overlord's Bloodmail, tank. So that's the best build path. This build works every single lobby. You pair this with Phase Rush, which I'll talk about at the end. It will be timestamp for your convenience, but that's the best build path and its variations. The second build path is how will you win more. So this is Black Cleaver, Heartsteel, Overlords, tank item, then Sterax. So this is for when you are in a winning position against an enemy laner and the enemy team don't have any percent HP. So this, in my opinion, is probably the second strongest build and the most consistent second strongest build. Because Urgot is in this really weird power vacuum right now, where you have a strong level 1, strong level 2, strong level 3. Your 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 are weak. 9 is strong. 10 is a bit weaker. 11 is a bit weaker. 12 is a bit weaker. 13, we spike really hard. And then you kind of enter this zone where you feel like you should be a strong carry, like a potent carry. But we're in a meta where, like, control mages are good. ADCs are, you know, the ADCs that are good right now, like, hard counter Urgot. Like, AP Cogmore, Caitlyn, and etc, etc. So, Urgot is in this really weird space where we need to build a certain way to get value from our champion. So, the way we're getting value from our champion in this instance, when we're winning more, is building Heartsteel. Heartsteel obviously gives you permanent scaling. It allows you to go to the moon. If you can actually pull off Heartsteel, you end up just becoming like an unkillable raid boss. and this build enables Sterax. So we're not building Sterax in the Urgot anymore, unless we're building Heartsteel. Just so you have a comparison, Sterax last patch on the third item slot would give you about a 1,300 shield. Sterax on the current patch with three items would give you about a 700 to 600 shield. The item is absolutely nerfed, and I don't recommend you build this item pretty much ever, unless you're building Heartsteel. And speaking of Heartsteel, there's a second iteration of this build, where you go Overlords, Heartsteel, BC Tank, and then Sterax. This is just the option to build this win more build, but when you're playing as a champion, you don't need to rush armor cleave against. But in my opinion, Overlord Bloodmail, better on the third item slot, second item slot. Black Cleaver is still ultimately the king, even though it's not an S tier item, but you should be building Overlord's Bloodmail every single game. And next build, this is for ranged champions. So if you're playing against Quinn, Teemo, etc., etc., you want to be playing Stridebreaker, BC into Shojin, then Overlords, then Tank. So when you're building Stridebreaker, you always want to be running Approach Velocity in your rune page. Stridebreaker went from being low S tier from last patch, or like mid of S tier, and now it's in the minus A minus tier. So it got pretty hard with the changes, but it's still a good item and it has its tools. So make sure whenever running with Stridebreaker, you're running this rune page that you see on screen right now. You want to be running this rune page with Ignite mostly, because you're playing Approach Velocity. You can play TP with it if you want, if you're confident enough that you can play Urgot's Kit good enough against a ranged champion. But in my opinion, this page works best with Ignites. But if you're playing Stridebreaker, make sure you run Approach Velocity. Next build, this is Lethality. So Lethality, this has been recommended by Camon. If you don't know Camon, here's him, smiling. What a happy man. He's a challenger in EU West, one of the best Urgots. He plays in the German Professional League, if you haven't heard of him. I'll link his socials in the description. But this is his recommended build, with my slight twist on it, to just make it a little bit more consistent, because I play about 20 games of it, just like, you know, vibe it out. So we go Opportunity or Yomu start, depending on who you're laning against. I think you go Opportunity first, if you're against something like Cassiopeia, who's a mobile, and make sure Q reliable to hit. Or you go Yomu's against something like Quinn, which is like highly mobile and is a little bit harder to hit your Qs. So Opportunity against champions that you can consistently land Q. Yomu's when you need the movement speed to catch up to enemy champions. And then after that, you go Edge of Night, which I think is the best Lethality item for Urgot right now, into Sereldas, into Guardian Angel. So this is a valid way to play hyper carry Urgot, but it has hyper amounts of risk going in with it. So I think if I were to tier the playlist, the playstyles on this video, I think the Black Cleaver into Shojin playstyle, probably S plus. That's the best way to play Urgot right now. Well, let's say S. It's not like a great to play, you know, like BC Shojin. It just plays Urgot at its core, so it's just S. This is just the best way to play Urgot. I think Lethality lingers in the A plus tier to the A tier. And if you do it into the wrong lobby, it's F. So you can play Lethality every single lobby, but I wouldn't recommend it into tanks. So if you're doing Lethality against tanks, obviously you can't kill them. You want to play Lethality into lanes where you can actually kill them. So play Lethality into ranged top lane, if you feel like you're comfortable enough to play risky. Play it into like Jace, you play it into Gnar, champions that you can actually kill. This playstyle will work better for those who can get kills in lane and generate solo pressure on the side lane. But keep in mind, this build cannot group up. You will die within a couple of like hits. Like one Syndra Art is like 70% of your health. Do not group up when doing this build and let your team that know that you can't group up. It's pointless. You will feel that you want to group up because you're a Urgot player, but you can't. There's some instances where you can group up, but like when you have like E-Flash R. But if the enemy team is posturing with a good team comp, they have Orianna, Syndra, Caitlyn, blah, 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 you're not grouping up. So Lethality plays to hyper win lane and hyper slip push. Obviously, you play this rune page with Ignite. You play this playstyle with Ignite. Your rune page is PTA, Triumph, Legend, Bloodline, and Cutdown. Secondary runes, Approach Velocity, and Reboot. You can swap this out for more Ignites if you would like to instead of Approach Velocity. But I think Approach Velocity is just king right now. In my opinion, the way you should gauge this is, do you need movement speed or do you need more flashes? If you need more flashes, etc. Example, you need more flashes against champions that are immobile, but are also very strong. So against Cassiopeia, you can have a valid argument for both, because you want the movement speed to approach her, and you also want more flashes to E-flash her on cooldown. So that's my justification for it. Do you need more flash? You go for Cosmic Insight, do you need more movement speed, approach velocity? So 80% of the time, it's approach velocity. 20% of the time, it's Cosmic Insight. All right, this is build 6. This is the Hyper Tank frontline. This is Bishi, Shojin, Jaxo, Deadman's Fawn. This is when you are needed as the frontline, sole frontline tank. It's the best way to play Urgot and then still be defensive in teamfights. It gives you the most amount of survivability. If you don't need magic resist, you don't go Force of Nature, you go for Warmogs. If you don't need Deadman's for armor, then you go Warmogs. Warmogs is still a great item on Urgot, just very situational in its application. But still a great item, does its purpose, does its job. Just a little bit slower than it did before, but still a great item. But this is the best way to play just generic tank Urgot frontline. So this build path is for the players who like to play Urgot at its traditional core. I like to play Urgot as a bruiser. I like to go to team fights. This is the build for you. So, new rune page. Phase Rush. So the rune page on screen right now, it's Phase Rush, Nimbus Cloak, Celerity, Gathering Storm. Secondaries, Overgrowth, and Conditioning. So this is important because this is probably the best way and most optimal way to play Urgot right now. Every single lobby. So I mostly recommend Phase Rush when you are playing against lanes that you can't interact with. So think Olaf, think Nasus, think Rumble. What this does is it makes your early game much weaker. So I'm going to give you two charts on the screen right now. And this is how Urgot plays with his rune pages. So your PTA on the left and Phase Rush on the right. This is how they're being compared, right? But the way you're using Phase Rush is like you have Stridebreaker from level 1. So you're using Phase Rush practically like a Stridebreaker to disengage, engage. It just makes your laning phase much more consistent, but it makes it much weaker. So if you're someone like me who plays like hyper-aggressive, like terrorist, you probably shouldn't run Phase Rush. You should probably just stick to PTA Ignite. But if you're playing Phase Rush, make sure you're running TP. Don't run Scorch with this build because, you know, Scorch is a laning aggressive one, but Phase Rush takes all the aggression out of your laning phase. So don't go Scorch if you've been playing Phase Rush, but it's good. It's consistent. It's a bit weak for laning phase, but it makes your mid and late stronger. So weaker early for stronger mid late. For PTA, I would like to talk to the secondary runes for a little bit. So if you're going PTA this patch, you're going PTA, Triumph, Legend, Buttline, Cut Down, and then your secondaries are really important here. Because there's three ways to play the secondaries. So on the screen, you'll see the three secondaries I recommend. If you're playing Inspiration, you're playing Approach Velocity plus 3 Boots. If you're playing Resolve, it's Overgrowth Conditioning. And if you're playing Sorcery, it's Nimbus Cloak Scorch. So the Nimbus Cloak Scorch is invented by Korean Urgots. Resolve second is recommended by Quanti and Nyangus. Inspiration second is my... I think Approach Velocity plus 3 Boots fell off a little bit when it comes to this patch. Because tankiness in general and HP stacking is just a little bit more valuable than aggression. So my playstyle, I would put it in the A tier. I think Quanti and Nyangus Overgrowth Conditioning is probably the S tier. And the Scorch Nimbus Cloak is probably about A tier also. So if you're going for like just build consistently purely, you should play Phase Rush every single lobby. If you're playing like a traditional Urgot player who wants aggression, you should go for the PTA with Inspiration second or Resolve second. If you're a hyper-aggressive Urgot player, you should play PTA with Sorcery second. But you have to keep in mind you can't run this into tanks. It's for just playing lanes really aggressive. So some situational items I recommend for you are Profane Hydra, Hullbreaker, Jaxo, Redemption. So let's start with Profane Hydra. Profane Hydra is a carry-oriented win more item. So you want to build... Well, it's hard to recommend Profane Hydra because it is a very mid item, but I think it's definitely something we should keep experimenting with to see if there's any merit to it. So Profane Hydra, it works in the best in the win more slot. It's just pure damage. It doesn't give Urgot anything, but if you're able to... I think the best way I can say this is if you're able to consistently play Urgot well, and this mostly works in low elo, I wouldn't recommend this in high elo. This consistently works in low elo as a carry tool. So if you're playing in a lane, you're 5-0, you have Black Cleaver, and you want to keep winning more, but the enemy team have percent HP, I think you should go Profane Hydra and try out a more carry-oriented playstyle. You start playing for the enemy jungle, you start pushing your lanes really hard, you start killing your laner even easier. So I think Profane Hydra, it's a B-tier item, but I think it has its merits. Hullbreaker. Hullbreaker is a bit overrated by Urgot players, in my opinion. I think Hullbreaker is a pretty mid item. I put it in a direct mid or B. But if they have a Shen, if they have something you know is going to roam, like a Quinn, if you can kill your laner and they don't, you don't need a BC to kill them in the 1v1, then sure, Hullbreaker can get value by getting turrets. But keep in mind, the main value of Hullbreaker is by taking plates with its passive. If you can't access turret plates without Hullbreaker, don't go Hullbreaker. You only build Hullbreaker on the first item slot. You can on the second item slot, but there's always something better in slot. Like, if you're doing BC Hullbreaker, you feel very bad because BC Shoujin is just so much more superior. So, Hullbreaker, I do recommend it if you are in certain situations, but just keep in mind, it's a bit weaker than every other item. Jekyll, this is going to be a controversial one. This is just my personal opinion. Usually, my opinion is based on what the collective of high-yield Urgot mains think. I try to give you a representation of what we all suggest and recommend. Like, the Phase Rush build is recommended by Yangus. The the Sorcery Rune page is recommended by the Korean Urgot. Yada, yada, yada. So, Jekyll, I think, is only an item that I'd really like to build when I have double Enchanter. The reason is, Urgot's playstyle just plays really differently to what Jekyll wants to achieve. I think Jekyll is a great Volley Bear item. I just don't think it's a great Urgot item because it's hard for Urgot to get into a combat and then stay in a combat. I think Jekyll is better the later you buy it, but I see Urgot mains have a bias to buy it on the third item slot. I think Jekyll is like A tier when you build on the fifth item slot and you have like double Enchanters. If you have double Enchanters and it's late game, this item is like S tier, right? Because you can live for a long time. You have a lot of tank opportunities, especially in a winning more position. Because if you're winning more, if you're like 4,000 health, unkillable raid boss, and everyone in your level 18, everyone else in the game is like level 15, level 16, they're not going to be able to kill you because of Jekyll. So I like Jekyll more from the winning more position and when I have Enchanters. I don't recommend it broadly as much as other Urgot players do, but this is my personal opinion. You can take it with a pinch of salt. And just like this one, this is also my personal opinion. Redemption. I'm going to link you the other patch notes where I talked about Redemption for like 3 minutes because I don't want the video to drag on. So, 07s, talk to you later. Lots of patches, lots of stuff going on. I will continue to keep my finger on the pulse and keep you guys updated. And I will see you next patch rundown. Bye-bye!